You ever see a t-shirt that made you stop scrolling and laugh out loud? Like this one or this? You're probably thinking, how the heck are people coming up with these type of design ideas? What if I told you, you can create designs just like this without ever opening Photoshop? No design degree, just you and an AI tool called Ideogram. By the end of this video, you'll know how to write hilarious, trendy prompts that get attention. Use Ideogram AI to generate viral t-shirt designs in minutes and turn those ideas into real products for your print-on-demand business. Who am I? My name is RJ Martinez. I have generated over $400,000 all time with my print-on-demand business. I mainly sell on Amazon Merch on Demand. So I understand the research process and design concepts when it comes to anything like this. It definitely took me time to learn this, but it's all about patience and understanding the concept of a design or your audience, who you're designing for. One thing I always say is create something that someone wants and it makes it easier for them to purchase. It's easier said than done, so I understand that. Make sure you guys smash that like button. Let's get into the content. Let me guess, you've opened up Ideogram, typed in something like funny cat t-shirt and got some weird mess back. Yeah, we all have been there. The truth is, what you write matters just as much as how you write it. Write your prompt like you're describing the t-shirt to a friend. Seriously, pretend that you're texting a friend. So we have this prompt right here. Imagine a chubby raccoon holding a pizza, 90s cartoon style, bold retro text that says snack bandit. All right, so we're gonna leave this here and we're gonna just leave everything as is, 4.5 aspect ratio, 3.0 default, the 3.0 model, and then everything else is just as is, okay? And then we're gonna go ahead and hit, actually, let me show this right here, pull this over to public and hit generate. Boom, that's your prompt right here. Let's go ahead and break it down into a formula that you can actually use to give you a better understanding of what I'm talking about. And what we're gonna do is, this is the formula right here, okay? So niche or subject, funny or emotional hook, visual style or design element, okay? And then also just keep in mind like the text, whatever you wanna add to it. So we'll go ahead and here's one right here. So grumpy old cat sitting on a throne. Okay, this is like, so this is the niche or subject, right? And then this is gonna be like, so like the pause before peasants. So this is gonna be like, this is gonna be the funny, this is gonna be like the hook or the text right here, right? So we'll put that in there, kind of text, give you an idea. Bold medieval font, fantasy cartoon style. So the visual style and the design element right there, okay? So that's the idea, you get the idea of what works, break it down. So here is one prompt, right? And then the same thing over here, we'll show, I'm gonna show you another one. Go ahead and grab another one and kind of break that down, give you an idea. Retro dad doing barbecue with sunglasses, grill sergeant, okay? And then vintage sunset colors, t-shirt design layout. So here's another one right here that we did, another prompt that we go ahead, went ahead and just broke down. So there's two examples for you right there. Now, the next styles right here, this is gonna help you, this is a little tip right here. This is going to help you with get the right style for the AI prompts down. So, vintage graphic sticker style, worn print look, cartoon outline, bold text only. So like when you see stuff like this, just think of different ideas. And there was another video that I went over everything about like different keywords that you can use to help you create the style of design that you want. So for example, even let's say t-shirt, using t-shirt design, because your goal is to help the AI create something really cool for you, right? So you can see, just I would literally start generating a different list of different ideas so you can build out your whole style. So when you're going in to create these different prompts, you have a different idea of what you're going to create. Or if you can come back and look at your cheat sheet to help you, okay, this is a good idea, this is a good one, this is a good style, I wanna try this style, and then you can just build it out on top of everything that you're doing. And if you're even doing like any type of line art or anything like that for coloring books, just think of different keywords that you're gonna be using for the coloring book. So this is very important too as well, which is really nice, because like once you get the idea and the concept and you're going, just think about how you're gonna be doing the whole, your whole styles and stuff like that. Line art, and so even do like maybe a coloring book, line art or outline, coloring book outline, or image outline, stuff like that. So just think of just different sayings, different ideas with this right here. My styles. Also too, just when you keep in mind when you're doing this, don't overcomplicate it, right? When you're looking at this, you're not writing a novel, you're not writing some crazy prompt, right? And we've all seen, I've seen people write these crazy prompts. They're like a paragraph. I'm like, dang, how the heck are you even doing this? How are you even thinking about this? So think about it like this. One visual idea. Let's do one strong visual idea. Okay. Clear style equals design. Okay. And there's a few different ways, like niche plus niche subject, funny or emotional hook text, and then visual style design element. This is basically what we just went over, but like this more of a simple terms in a way. The more humor you put into the niche, just keep in mind the more original the design's going to be compared to your competition, right? Because if everyone's watching this video or doing what I'm sharing right here, it's most likely they're gonna catch on and understand it. But just keep in mind as you're doing your research on your end, you're putting the work into it. So it's you're leveraging that, your own personal brain power to help you create an original design that no one else is going to create by adding a little bit more into the actual prompt. All right, let's go ahead and write a prompt together and let me give you the whole concept and the whole idea behind it. And let's say like a funny animal, for example. So a funny animal that has some type of virality around it and that people just think it's like cute, weird type of idea, right? So right here, animal, personality or joke, and then a visual style. Okay, so here we go. Angry goose holding a baseball bat, okay? Standing in front of a barn, and the text is gonna be don't honk with me, bold character style, right? Vintage t-shirt design, clear readable text, right? So you can see everything that we put together. It's not nothing too crazy, but it's just obviously telling the AI like this is what we want. Let me go over here, come over here into the AI, and we'll go ahead and just boom, copy and paste that, and then we'll go ahead and hit generate. And it's generating the prompt for us. And if you haven't been messing with the 3.0 with the Ideogram, it's pretty dang good. It's like it understands simple like prompts. It does a really great job at that, okay? You can see the bold text, right? I want you to understand that bold, so the vintage clear readable text, and that clear, so the clear readable text, you can see that's pretty good at the text right there. It says Goose Estate. That's pretty cool. This is pretty cool, right? And by looking at the design tools, you can see how clear the image is, right? You just see how clear the image is, the barn. The text is really clean. Everything, though, how fast it was created within seconds. And then one thing, too, as well, the goose, like sometimes it doesn't get the animal correctly, so you may have to just come in there and redo it again, so regenerate it. Just keep that in mind. It's AI, so you're doing as best as possible to help it understand what you want, and then it creates it for you. Now, one thing too, you can add, I added a little bit into here, so let me go ahead and click on this, but the prompt right here, I said, make the text larger and clearer, keep the cartoon style, add an angry face on the goose. So something like this, you see the different design style it created, don't honk with me. That's a pretty cool one, right? And then don't honk with me, you can see there's another one, right? Don't honk with me. And it seems like it brought the text that could just pop, it's like, it's more bold, it's pushed out a little bit more in the design. And which is really cool, okay? And you can come over here to the right-hand side if you want to download the PNG, you can definitely do so by just hitting the download the PNG or download it in a JPEG. You can even upscale it within here too as well, and you can remove the background. Now, here are some of the other prompts that I've actually created over here so you get an idea of what I did over here. So so with this one right here, went ahead and did the magic prompt, but for the most part, it understands with the 3.0 model, it understands exactly what type of prompt you want. And then you can see like the other versions it created over here, right? You can see that some of it does it with magic prompts, some it doesn't. You're gonna see right over here, all the information here as far as the prompt and you get an idea. But look at this one right here, black background with the phrase, I love or I heart fat pitches, using a baseball heart symbol to replace the word love design in bold sports style font, and it understood exactly what I was talking about. Now let's go over here. on my Hoot. Okay, you can see right here. Look, it's very simple prompt. A dark blue background featuring a vintage style owl illustration on a branch with the text "I am a Hoot" above it, set against a retro sunset striped background, right? And then it did, that's the prompt I put in, and then it went ahead and did the rest. But for the most part, look at that prompt, is a very simple prompt and it understands. Even when it didn't do the magic prompt, look how clean this is, okay? And then this one right here, Datasaurus, same thing with this one too. You can see the prompt right here. This one was a little bit longer, but you can see exactly what we got done over here, okay? And if you guys want to follow me too over here on Ideogram, you can go ahead and do that. You get, so you can get an idea of like certain prompts. I'll start creating a little bit more prompts back here, so to help you guys understand different design concepts and stuff like that. Okay, I'll put that link down below in the description. If you guys want to sign up with the Ideogram, you can go ahead and do that, and it'll be down below. So the prompt too as well, you're gonna see the humorous cartoon style illustration of a white chicken with a red comb on orange beak, standing with a surprised expression above it. The text "chicken game" is written in bold, slightly distressed lettering, followed by a "don't look at the chicken" in a smaller font. The phrase "game over" is written near the chicken's feet. You're obviously telling the prompt, or the AI, to, you're creating the prompt and telling the AI like where you want stuff positioned. Keep that in mind. If it's not, when you create something, it's not the style that you want, you can tell it to position the text in a certain area, and then boom, you can come up with something like this. So just get that idea. And this is like the whole concept. This is why I'm sharing this with you, so it can give you an insight exactly of how to create these. Now, sometimes it does take a little bit of time, but once you get it down correctly, it's all worth it, because you're like, yeah, this is the actual prompt that I wanted. Now, right here, mama of a sweet one, you're gonna see right here, this one was something very simple, some simple text-based design. And then instead of the O, it put, went ahead and put a cookie there, right? Which is pretty cool. White background with the phrase "mama of the sweet one" and pastel colors, incorporating a chocolate chip cookie illustration, replacing the letter O in one. See that? Bam, simple, right? But obviously, the detailed prompt so the AI can understand exactly what to do. Okay, see, beam, different colors, pretty cool, huh? All right, so you got your AI generated design. It looks amazing. But before you go rush to upload it to Etsy or Amazon or even Redbubble or TeePublic or whatever platform that you're on, let's make sure that it's actually print ready. Because here's the truth, even a great design can flop if the text is unreadable and the layout is off or the resolution is too low. Here's a quick checklist to make sure your design is POD ready, to make sure your design is POD safe and shop ready. Number one, check the text. AI sometimes messes up the lettering or the spelling. Zoom in, does it actually say what you want it to say? Or if it's jumbled or weird, either fix it with a free tool like Canva or Photopea. Now, certain tools, right, you can fix with the free design tools that it gives you. Sometimes you can't. Keep that in mind. Or go back and regenerate with more prompt detail, like clear, bold text, easy to read. That's going to help the AI understand exactly what you want. Number two, crop and center. AI designs can be off center or too much white space. Make sure the main graphic is balanced and fills most of the canvas. You want the image to look good on a shirt, not just on screen. Number three, size it right. Most platforms like Amazon Merch on Demand or Merch by Amazon, Redbubble, or even Etsy need high resolution PNGs, usually 4,500 by 5,400 or similar, 300 DPI. Ideogram doesn't export those sizes by default. Upscale your images by using a tool like Upscale. You can upscale inside of Ideogram AI or even use Let's Enhance. There are a few different softwares that you can help you enhance these images. Some of them you may have to pay for, keep in mind. And then making sure that you export it in a transparent PNG if you're uploading it to a t-shirt. Number four, stay safe from trademarks or copyrights, right? This is one of the most important things when it comes to creating and finalizing your design. You want to stay away from Disney, Nike, or any celebrity faces. Don't upload any of those because it's not worth the takedown. Just keep in mind, if you don't have the rights to use it, do not use it. You can use tools like TM Hunt to help you check for these type of trademarks. If there's certain sayings out there in the world that are trademarked, you can't use a certain phrase, so you want to make sure that you're double checking that. Sticking to original ideas and concepts, funny ideas, animals, food, dad jokes, anything you come up with that AI has helped you visualize. And that's it, a clean pro looking design ready for the shelves.
So you know exactly how to write fun, high converting prompts
use Ideogram AI to generate viral design ideas, prep them for real-world print-on-demand products. The truth is, you don't need to be a designer. You just need an idea and a little humor and the right prompt formula. Whether you're trying to build a side hustle, go viral with a niche joke, or just create something that you're proud of, this is how to start. So here's your challenge. Think of a niche that you love because this makes it so much easier to create designs for. Write a prompt using the formulas that I shared with you. Drop it into Ideogram and see what you get. If you got something funny, please reach out to me. You can DM me on Instagram or leave a comment down below in the description of this video. If you need help, drop your prompt in the comments. And if you want more, make sure you subscribe to this channel and give this video a thumbs up. I got more tutorials, prompt hacks, and design hacks coming soon. And if you want to see how I do my design research, watch this video right here next. Thank you very much for watching. Peace out.